Alright guys, I've been on a Technics frenzy lately. I just yesterday bought a Technics cassette tech at a flea market, and today I found a Technics SA206 receiver and a Technics SLD20 direct drive turntable with a P-mount cartridge installed, both being thrown out. And they both work, despite being soaked by the rain. They both work, no problem. As you can see, the receiver is on right now. I have a crappy Philips speaker connected to it. This was originally part of a 5-channel surround system. See, surround sound speaker system. It's really crappy, sounds like crap. But I was just using it for testing purposes in case something was wrong. I have it connected in the back. I also got a whole bunch of wires with the receiver. I'm assuming that's for the antenna. In fact, right here's the... I think it's the AM loop antenna or something. Clips on back here. But everything works. I can't pick up any stations on the radio because A, it's night, and B, I don't really have an antenna properly connected to this thing, but I have it set to the phono input. I have the RCA cables and the ground connected to the back of here, and the turntable works perfectly fine. Now, it has a Shure MT-105P P-mount cartridge on, and it's definitely going to need a replacement stylus. I mean, it still plays, but it's very distorted. You can tell that it's worn out. Unfortunately, I looked on a couple different websites, and a replacement stylus for this thing is like $40. So, I'll just have to, either find the replacement stylus for a good price, or, I don't know, find a cheaper cartridge or something. I don't know. I actually have a linear tracking turntable that has a good cartridge on it, so I might be able to swap that out. But it still plays. It sounds like crap, but it plays. Probably tell how bad that sounds, but this is a pretty worn-out record too. Looks like the needle scratched it. Speed's adjusted perfectly. But once I get a replacement stylus and or cartridge for this, I think this would be a nice setup. I even got the 45 adapter with it. Didn't get the dust cover, but that's okay. I don't really care about that. Because it's a P-mount system, it tracks very lightly. Right now it's set to just 1 gram. It has one for the anti-skating. It's a semi-automatic turntable. It has auto-return, as you can see. You just press the stop button or wait for it to get to the end of the record, and it automatically returns. But it doesn't have automatic cueing or anything like that. But that's okay. It has a cueing lever thing down here, which is still kind of wet. Like I said, these were both out in the rain. But, I'm quite pleased with what I found today. Once this turntable's all fixed up, and by that I just mean a replacement stylus, and once I clean this out, I think they'll both be very nice, whether I decide to keep them or sell them. So, that's all for today. Hope you enjoyed the video on the Technics SLD20 direct drive turntable and the SA206 stereo receiver. Peace.